So in a week I'm going back to Wisconsin where I attend university. I'm going to vlog the flight and everything, but really this is the last video in which I have a chance to show you a glimpse of Mexico. And I want to do that because I love it. I say that genuinely. I'm not hugely patriotic, but I value everything that this country has injected into my personality, moral and work ethics. I'm not naive. Mexico is dealing and has always dealt with a lot of problems. And it's a scary at times, yes, and instability is a stranger to its people, also yes, but it's home. But you don't want me going on about that, because Mexico is also sexy. She is fine looking. She is a hottie. So I'm going to show you two of my favorite types of Mexicos, urban and coast. And to get to both places, we'll take Mexico City's metro. Fun fact, Mexico City's subway system is the second largest and busiest in North America, only behind the New York City subway. Alright, at the time we're in central Mexico, but we're going to the south, to Quintana Roo. That's the state where Cancun is. Are you a college kid or a borderline alcoholic golfer? Chances are you know of this place. Welcome to beautiful Quintana Roo. This is a cenote. The word comes from a Mayan term that means hole with water, and we're basically the jacuzzis of the Mayans. This one specifically is called Cenote Azul. Azul is Spanish for blue, and it's called that because the water of this cenote is blue. Another Spanish word for you is explicación, which means explanation, which you really didn't need for anything that I just told you. Am I funny? I can't tell.
Esperanza de mis días y en estas melodías yo comparto a ti mi vida paso a paso y despacito llévame hasta donde quieras que yo tengo tanta historia que soltar.
So that was a bit of the beautiful south. Now we'll go to Mexico City's Centro Histórico, once also known as the capital of the Aztec Empire, now known as downtown. So as I said, this place used to be Tenochtitlan before the Spaniards, you know, conquered us and gave us Spanish, I guess. My native tongue would be a smooth Nahuatl if it wasn't for those fucks. Kidding, realistically, we would have just been taken by another country. They had ships, we had spears. We were too pure. So that is the last glimpse of Mexico I can give you for a while. I hope you liked the visuals and the history and the humor. The visuals came naturally. My country's a knockout. But try coming up with jokes about history. I spend way too much energy trying to be funny. My life's a struggle, you guys. All jokes aside, because it wouldn't be a Diego Pedrosa video without some sort of emotion being spilled. I'll tell you once again why I love my country. Because it's home. The people I grew up with live here. The people I love the most live here. This is my second year of college, and a year ago when I got to Wisconsin for the first time, I was warned about homesickness. But apart from the food, I didn't miss Mexico. I missed its people. I don't get homesick, I get people sick. Of course I'll miss being nothing but stupid with my friends, yelling to and being yelled at by my family, and my wee cats. Because that is Mexico to me. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next when I fly to the States. God fucking knows what's expecting me there. And that's good. That's okay.